Elon Musk is about to change yet another industry with his new invention. Elon Musk is undoubtedly one of the richest men in the world, even by just judging from his intriguing portfolio of enterprises. There's SpaceX, which is working on a voyage to Mars, and Tesla, which is known for producing high-performance, high-tech electric automobiles. He asserts that his Hyperloop concept has the potential to fundamentally alter the way people travel. And even his boring company, which seeks to discover innovative approaches to the construction of tunnels, is kind of fascinating. But which of these will end up having the greatest impact on the world? Is it shooting people to Mars, or is it his accidental invention of new batteries? Everyone in the world relies on batteries more and more frequently with each passing year. By the end of 2023, sales of electric cars will have surpassed 10% of the total market for vehicles worldwide, and it is anticipated that they will reach 30% by the end of the decade. The policies of many nations will only serve to hasten the ascent of this trend. For instance, the climate legislation currently in effect in the United States invests billions of dollars in manufacturing incentives for electric vehicles and batteries. The European Union and several states in the United States have passed legislation prohibiting the sale of gasoline-powered automobiles beginning in the year 2035. During the changeover, a large number of batteries, both high-quality and more affordable varieties, will be required. Because of this, every research team is putting up their best effort to develop a new generation of batteries that will one day resolve this global problem. Every manufacturer of automobiles is engaged in a race to build a battery for the next generation that is more efficient, can store more energy, and can be charged more quickly. Now there are rumors stating that Elon Musk's research team accidentally discovered a new type of battery that will irrevocably transform the electric vehicle industry. The need for better batteries. Most electric vehicles today are powered by lithium-ion batteries, which have been around for a while and are also used in computers and cell phones. The cost of today's electric vehicles is beginning to approach that of gas-powered cars, and they can go hundreds of miles between charges due to years of development that have helped drive down prices and increase performance. University research centers and commercial organizations are looking into ways to advance the technology, aiming to increase capacity while simultaneously reducing charging times and cost. Batteries that are even more reasonably priced are needed if we are going to go full-blown EV, because they will make it possible for electric vehicles to travel much further on a single charge and will reduce the cost of grid storage. At the same time, concerns over the supply of crucial battery components like cobalt and lithium are pushing researchers to investigate alternatives to conventional lithium-ion chemistry. The evolution of batteries. Batteries have three parts: the electrolyte, the anode, and the cathode. The electrolyte holds together the cathode and the anode. The electrolytes perform their function by facilitating the movement of ions from the cathode to the anode. We first started with the liquid electrolyte battery, but because of the physical limitations of a liquid electrolyte, these batteries performed wonders for years but reached their limit in terms of energy cell density. This simply means we need a fundamentally different battery if we want our phones, watches, and electric automobiles to operate for longer periods and charge more quickly. So came the solid-state battery. When it comes to solid-state batteries, the name pretty well sums up everything you need to know about them. Because it was so difficult to achieve, manufacturing solid-state batteries were considered a science fiction concept until recently. Now, everyone is aiming to develop a miniature solid battery that is incredibly compact with no wasted area so that it may be charged more quickly and last considerably longer. There is no doubt that the chemistry of solid-state batteries will have far-reaching impacts. Compact solid-state batteries may be the key to improving the life of the batteries in our smartphones and enabling smart watches to charge in seconds rather than hours. And you guessed it, making it possible for electric automobiles to go for thousands of kilometers without needing a charge. Solid-state batteries are a crucial technology required to advance the EV revolution into its next stage. This is the reason why industry insiders refer to them as forever batteries. Problem with the current solid-state batteries. The problem with solid-state batteries is dendrites. Those little cracks appear in the solid electrolyte while charging and recharging the battery continues. Ultimately, they reach a size that can cause a short circuit in the battery. So the key to making significant progress in solid-state batteries will be to develop a solid electrolyte material that is resistant to the formation of dendrites. This is why it has been impossible for a single-layer battery cell to provide enough power for an automobile. However, the battery technology is functional in cells with 4 and 10 layers, and it is even beginning to function in cells with 16 layers. The advancement in computer power has been a driving reason behind the development of solid-state batteries. Currently, Tesla has 46 advanced battery packs installed in its Model Y electric vehicle, which is not even close to meeting the company's stated goal of achieving a cost reduction of 50% compared to conventional batteries. Because Tesla has not yet perfected dry mass electrode production, the company has recently hired a solid-state battery specialist who will be solely focused on the problem. Tesla is now using computer testing to save time and money in lab testing. According to forecasts made by analysts, this will make it possible for Tesla to cut the price of the Model Lite by an extra $5,280. The process of applying the current standard wet coating on the 4,680 cathodes is an unpleasant one that requires a lot of time, effort, and the use of chemicals that can be hazardous. On the other hand, the dry coating method may be utilized in a considerably more compact facility. It is also safer, more cost-effective, and more convenient. The game changer. Now, as Musk researchers were messing around trying to find out what works best, they stumbled upon lithium-sulfur batteries. According to sources, commercializing next-generation technologies such as lithium-sulfur presents more profit opportunities. For lithium-ion batteries, there are a lot of challenges to conquer and problems with the cost. However, the capabilities of a lithium-sulfur battery could be exponential. The production of mass quantities of these battery cells is expected to commence in 2027. Since lithium-sulfur batteries are significantly lighter but have the same energy density as existing ternary packs, they might be used in launching electric aircraft if everything goes according to plan. Because of their low price and high density, lithium-sulfur batteries have the potential to power the transportation of the future if they are ever commercialized. Sulfur is an element that is both common and inexpensive. Because there are huge quantities of it on Earth, it is common to see large yellow piles outside of fossil fuel plants after it has been processed to remove its natural gas and oil content. Yet, electrochemists have never viewed sulfur as a tantalizing option for energy storage. But if successful, the battery would be able to store more energy and be manufactured at a lower cost than the lithium-ion batteries presently utilized in laptops and battery-powered automobiles. Another vital component of current lithium-ion batteries is cobalt, which is predominantly mined in the Democratic Republic of the Congo, where human rights violations are widespread in the cobalt mines. The current lithium-ion battery pack costs approximately $150 per kilowatt hour. A lithium-sulfur battery might be substantially less expensive and dependent on troublesome areas than the existing lithium-ion battery pack. This is because sulfur is readily available and affordable. Today, electric vehicles have a range of approximately 300 miles per charge. However, a lithium-sulfur battery has the potential to triple that mileage. Challenges. Sulfur behaves erratically, and lithium is a difficult element. Combining these two components gives you quite challenging chemistry to work with. One of the problems with lithium-sulfur batteries is that the element sulfur, which serves as the cathode, goes through a phase transition while the battery is charged and drained. It goes from being a solid to a liquid and then back to being a solid again. Many attempts to create lithium-sulfur batteries have resulted in batteries that have poor performance and dendrites. However, Elon Musk now believes that Tesla will be able to construct a battery cell worthy of consideration in around 1 year. Because of the twofold increase in energy density, the lithium-sulfur battery may be able to power a vehicle with only half the weight of conventional batteries. We shouldn't expect the first lithium-sulfur batteries to be used to power automobiles on the roads when they finally leave the lab. The initial clients might be determined by how lightweight the batteries are. That's all from this video. What do you think is more cost-effective, the production of lithium-sulfur batteries or solid-state batteries? See you at the next one!